In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a particle logo animation without using any plugins in After Effects, so let's get to it. First, I'll create a new composition, name it render. It will be 1920x1080, 30 frames per second and 10 seconds for the duration, click OK. Then drag the logo to the timeline, press S on a keyboard to adjust the scale if needed. I'll decrease mine so it is nicely in the center of the composition. Then I'll right click on the logo, select Precompose, name this Precomp logo. And make sure Move Attribute is highlighted, then click OK. Now open Effects and Presets window and search for CC Ball Action and add this to the logo composition. I'm going to make the animation 2 seconds long. If you want to make the animation longer, simply put the time indicator further into the timeline. So I'll move the time indicator to 2 seconds, create keyframes for Scatter and Twist Angle, then press U to see the keyframes on the timeline, move the time indicator at the start and set Scatter to 500 and twist angle to -1 in the cycles, and that'll give us this kind of animation. Here in effect controls, we're able to change the type of the animation, like the rotation axis and twist property. So you get various different ones. Each one gives you like a different angle and perspective. So you could try each one on your own and find something that you like. But I like to set the rotation axis to Z axis. And for the twist property, I set it to radius, and that'll give us this sort of like rotating animation. Then in effect controls, I'm going to set grid spacing to 2. That'll decrease the space between the particles and in turn make them a lot smaller, as you can see. Now I'm going to search for CC Force Motion Blur and add this to the composition. And this will add the sort of motion blur to the particles. I'm going to set motion blur samples to 16 and leave the shutter angle at 180. You can increase it if you want to get more motion blur, but this is fine, I think. Now I'm going to move the time indicator to 2 seconds, press T to bring up opacity, create keyframe and set opacity to 0%, then move 5 frames back, set opacity to 100%, and this will be the fade of the particles, fade out. Now I'm going to select the logo comp, go up to edit, duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. Here I'm going to select these two effects for the duplicated logo comp and delete them, then press T to bring up opacity. Select opacity keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistance, time reverse keyframes, and this will be the opposite. So as the particles fade out, the logo fades in, and that happens very quickly, so we don't even notice that moment. Now I'm going to add like an extra bounce animation at the end. So select the logo comp at the top, press S to bring up scale, create keyframe at 2 seconds, and set scale to 95%. Then I'll move 5 frames forward and set scale to 100%. Then select these two keyframes and move them to 1 second 28 frames, just 2 frames back. Then I'll also add CC light sweep effect and add it to the logo comp at the top. Here I'm going to set the width to 100 and sweep intensity to 50. Now again, I'm going to move to 2 seconds, create a keyframe for center of the light sweep, and here you will see this point. You can move it around and control the position of the light sweep. So I'll move it to the left like that, so it's not on the logo. Then I'll move 10 seconds forward and drag this point across to the other side like that, and this will give us the sort of like a light sweep at the end, so it makes the whole animation a bit more interesting. So let's do the preview. And here is our complete particle logo animation. We could add a background to this. So go up to layer, new solid. Name this one PG, click OK, place it below the layers. I'm going to search for ramp in effects and presets, add this to the PG comp. I'll select the start of ramp and place it into the center of the composition. For the ramp shape, I'll select the radial ramp. Then for the start color here, you can choose any one that you like. So maybe dark red for this one. And for the start, like a very dark blue, something like that. And I'll extend the end ramp. So I'll increase the Y position of it like that to kind of like create this sort of gradient. Or you click on swap colors if you don't like those. And I'll set ramp scatter to 50, like to minimize the amount of color bendings. And this is the animation, so let's preview it. And this is our complete particle logo animation in After Effects without using any plugins. As you can see, it is kind of simple and limited compared to something like Particular, but still you could create good enough particle logo animations if you wanted to without using any plugins. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.